And today we heard from Mayor Lori Lightfoot, as well as medical experts here at Rush, on just how we would prevent the spread of coronavirus should it arrive again here in Chicago.
Ebola was that wake-up call, like, wow, things that we thought that couldn't cross the ocean were going to come over here, and we actually had to be prepared for them. So we kind of got together as a group and we were thinking, what next?
Tiffany Workson, manager of infection prevention and control at Rush University Medical Center, says they are prepared. Rush is one of 35 hospitals in the United States designated as an Ebola treatment center 6 years ago, and that specialized training makes them experts in treating and containing coronavirus.
We have extremely well thought out, well planned responses in the event that the virus appears again in anyone else in Chicago.
While the city stands at the ready, experts say the average American shouldn't panic. Yet many are worried. Surgical masks sold out at drugstores and pharmacies across the country.
We probably get a phone call every 5 minutes, and we're probably having people come to the store every 15, 20 minutes asking for masks.
Some retailers are jacking up the price of masks on sites like Amazon. Doctors say there's no need to wear them here right now with no new cases in Illinois, but if you're going to buy them, be sure to get the right one.
The N95 masks actually filter out smaller particles. So airborne viruses are smaller particles than a regular mask would filter out. N95, though, to be really effective, you should be fit tested for it.
Meanwhile, the federal government is discussing increasing funding to battle the coronavirus, Democrats wanting $8.5 billion.
I support this request for a dramatic increase in funding for this purpose now, before it spreads across the United States, which God forbid it ever does.
And during President Trump's press conference just a few minutes ago, we did hear from a doctor who says a vaccine is in the works for coronavirus, but it does need to go through testing and trials, and that it would likely be 1 year to a year and a half before it would be available to the public. Live at Rush University Medical Center, Dana Rebick, WGN